Hey there, everyone. Well, congratulations, America. That was a wonderful thing to see. Mick chose the topic this week, which officially is, it has finally happened. Marriage equality has come to the United States of America. Let's talk about this and celebrate this huge victory. How does this decision personally affect you? And are you already making plans to get married? Do you think the crazy opposition will really, and I cut the topic off somehow, but I'll talk enough that you'll get the idea, right? It was a big victory. I was really quite blown away by it. The first thing I actually thought of was this channel, because if I hadn't listened to people like Jim and Jim, I wouldn't have even been aware that the United States didn't have uniform marriage equality. It's often when they rattle off countries with marriage equality was listed as just as a country as having marriage equality. And I learned a lot from this channel, and that was not true. And I remember when I first saw the reference to the Supreme Court that it was going to come up, it was on one of Jim from Ohio's videos. And I asked him, what's this, you know? And when he told me, he more or less told me enough to Google it so I could have a look. And I have to say, I never said this at the time because it sounded too negative. And also because I don't understand your Supreme Court system. But I was a bit worried. I was thinking, oh, this is a bit risky. Because in Australia at one point, we had one state that had marriage equality for several days. And it was taken to the High Court, which would be like your Supreme Court. And the High Court overturned it here, which meant all those marriages that had taken place were null and void. So my concern was, even though it would be wonderful if this is a fight that is won, what will happen to all those marriages if this is a fight that is lost? And so it wasn't only something to celebrate, it was a great relief to see it. Would I get married if I were in that situation? Let's just pretend I am. We don't have marriage equality, but I don't know. And I don't know that it makes any difference whether I would or wouldn't, or whether anyone does or doesn't. What the difference is that you can. And even if you're in a relationship where you're not married, that relationship is now validated by that law. You know, you may not get the legal privileges of actually going out and getting married. However, it's a culture and a society saying that this is a valid relationship. So I don't know. I think that if people had a desire and wanted to get married before this passed, I totally understand them rushing out and getting married because they've waited long enough. But most LGBT people I know would not rush out and get married because the law changed, because they're far too committed and intelligent for that. They would actually get married when they were ready to get married. And now they can. So that's great. Will the opposition to it increase, decrease? What will happen there? Over time, it's a statement that surely has to stick. Initially, there could be some repercussions for it. You know, when I talked, I have missed a few videos because of internet connections, which I'm bored of discussing, so I'm not going to discuss it. But at one point, when we were talking about Ireland, I said that had such a huge impact on Australia. Like it put this at a point where everyone had stopped even discussing it. There was no point, right? And then Ireland happened, and because it was by public vote, there was this huge surge in the news for a week about marriage equality, and all of a sudden the campaigning started again, and there was sort of some sort of hope and light at the end of the tunnel going on. And what was interesting then is when that was happening, at one point I got woken up at 2 o'clock in the morning by the police saying there's a cross burning in your front yard. And I wrote it off a bit. I was like, yeah, whatever, it's just those white supremacists again, like, yeah, don't worry about it that much. Because which sounds a bit blasé, but I live in a very supportive community. And so these are just people that have come in to do whatever they do. And the police said to me, no, we're taking it seriously because it's outside every LGBT house. It's not just your house. So that was interesting. It was a definite overreaction to what was seen as could be a possible bill put before Parliament, which never happened. The opposition tried to force it in, and they couldn't get it through. They couldn't even get it to Parliament, let alone get it heard. So I think you're going to have those knee-jerk, over-the-top reactions in the short term. In the long term, though, it can only be a significant shift in perspective, you know. It's a wonderful thing. And I also think, yeah, hopefully it has an impact here. Because surely the United States having it is just the ultimate embarrassment, right? You never know. Maybe soon. But who cares? We can just celebrate the US for now, huh? Because that's pretty amazing. I honestly, as I said at the beginning of this, was a bit concerned it was even going to the Supreme Court, because a part of me was thinking, oh no, what if this falls over? Sort of proves there's some risks worth taking, doesn't it? Anyway, congratulations, everyone, married or otherwise, and I'll see you next week. Bye for now.